Hi folks, my name is Mel Fernando, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through the Zero Trust Assessment. This is an optional part of the overall Zero Trust workshop, but it helps you find out more about your tenant configuration and provide recommendations to improve the end-to-end security configuration. Now, before you run the assessment, you need a user with at least the application administrator permission to be able to consent to these permissions to the PowerShell module when it runs. Once it's consented, you can use a global reader permission to run the actual assessment itself. So let's see how it works. Let me switch over to PowerShell. We start by installing the module. Called Zero Trust Assessment. And once the module is installed, you can then invoke the assessment. Now you will be prompted to sign in. And if it's the first time, you'll see the option to consent to the permissions. Once you've consented, you can head back to PowerShell and you can see the assessment running. Now, depending on the size of your tenant, it might take a few minutes to run. Now, once the assessment has finished, you'll be able to open the Excel file that it generates. Now, the Excel spreadsheet that it generates has a number of tabs. It includes information such as the tenant that it's been run on, the date it was executed on, and the user who ran the assessment. Now, let me walk you through the different tabs here. In the last two tabs, which are the assessment tabs, you'll see a list of the tests and the recommendations for them. Now, you can see here, for this tenant, it has the conditional access policy for workload identities. But you'll also see there are other recommendations which are shown as not started, which means these need to be configured in the tenant. If you click through to any one of these, you'll get the recommendations of what that setting is all about and what the remediation needs to be. The P numbers are for priority. So if it's P0, it's meant to be a higher priority. P1s are second, and then P2 are lower priority. Recommendations for you. You have one for identity and you have another for devices, which walks you through all of the recommendations for the devices. Now, if you head over to the other purple tabs, you'll find what we call the config for the tenant. So it gives you a summary of all of the different configuration settings in the tenant. So here you can see the Intune configuration. All of the options are laid out here as to how it's configured. So you can, at a glance, see all of these settings in one page. And similarly with the identity, you get a view of the conditional access policies for identity. And if you can, you can click through and view the details about the conditional access policies that have been defined in the tenant. I hope you found this useful. You can watch the rest of the videos in this series that walk you through the other tabs and how you can use them. Thanks.